The big tech companies have launched their fiercest attack yet on your right as an American to follow your conscience and to say what you believe.
We're taking a more proactive role in making sure that all of our partners and developers use our services for good. We're very focused on making sure that our recommendations and discovery surfaces aren't highlighting groups where people are repeatedly sharing misinformation or harmful content, and we're working hard to completely remove groups if they exist primarily to violate our policies or do things that are dangerous.
Dangerous like hurting other people? Or dangerous as in saying things that Mark Zuckerberg doesn't like or considers bad for business? Facebook released its latest enemies list. Alex Jones, Milo Yiannopoulos, Paul Joseph Watson, Louis Farrakhan, Laura Loomer, all of them were designated dangerous individuals and banned from Facebook and from its subsidiary Instagram. Alex Jones' company InfoWars was banned as well and described as a dangerous organization. How dangerous is InfoWars? Well, Facebook believes it's so dangerous that you can be banned from using the platform, Facebook, just for sharing its content unless you simultaneously denounce it. Let that penetrate for just one moment. Think about it, just for a second. Mark Zuckerberg is not simply censoring opinions. He's prescribing which political opinions you're allowed to have, which conversations all of us in this country can have about America.
The so-called standard of dangerous speech is so inherently subjective. There is essentially unfettered discretion on the part of these companies to pick and choose which ideas they agree with and think are not dangerous versus the ones they disagree with and think are dangerous. Regardless of your ideological views, you should be
exactly
very alarmed about that much power residing in these private companies.
Now, journalists are supposed to defend free speech. You would think that was their job since they make a living from it. But when corporate America issues an order, when Mark Zuckerberg says jump, their question is how high, Mr. Zuckerberg?
Why are they doing this now?
Well, it's a good question as to why they waited this long, but
yes, exactly.
Yeah. Alex Jones has been banned from Facebook for a long period of time, but now they banned him. They banned his like little underling, Paul Joseph Watson.
Now that they kicked them off the platform, that's great for now, but it doesn't roll back the clock.
Well, you have also excesses in the First Amendment and the Second Amendment right now. You know, I don't think that the forefathers said, well, you can say, you know, all sorts of hateful things and spread it around the world, literally spread it through the Internet.
I have no issue with it at all. I want them shut down. I want them silenced. I want them muted. I think they are horrible for our society.
Recently, the Poynter Institute, which is a nonprofit that's supposed to support journalism, put out a list of what they called unreliable news outlets. Can you imagine unreliable? Self-awareness in short supply in the journalism business. But Poynter crafted this list with the help of the Southern Poverty Law Center. So you can imagine who made the list. The Washington Free Beacon, the Daily Caller, the Daily Signal, the Washington Examiner. Basically everyone who's not CNN or MSNBC or precisely aligned with their politics. Poynter called for advertisers to blacklist and therefore bankrupt these news outlets, crush them. Their fellow progressives applauded. As far as they're concerned, this is total war.
The social media companies, as the Supreme Court itself said in a unanimous decision, have more power to control public discussion, not only conversations among our friends in a personal sense, but conversations about public policy issues, conversations
yes.
with political candidates. And we, the people who have sovereign power under our Constitution, can't responsibly exercise it if we are subject to arbitrary and discriminatory censorship by the powerful social media companies.
And this is the dirty little secret that most people who live or work in Washington, D.C. knows, is that these people all drink together, they all hang out together, they all go to the same places, they all, date each other's sisters. You know, this is a very incestuous cabal of people that we have now, and they're okay with these new masters of the universe in Silicon Valley telling us what not to do.
Why is no one defending the majority of Americans against this threat to our speech?
That's an extremely good question. You know, there actually is one person, one very prominent person out there who is calling for mass civil disobedience. And brace yourself, it's Snoop Dogg, who just
good.
Ordered all of his followers to start sharing Louis Farrakhan videos and footage on Facebook and Instagram. Good for him. I agree. Meanwhile, you have a Republican class. You have a sort of fence-sitting, milquetoast conservatives who are so terrified of having their own precious accounts taken away
exactly.
that they will not stand up for these people. They refuse to stand up for these people. They're frightened. And I'm sorry to say that the censors are coming for them next.
The social media companies are banking on weak-spined Republican politicians standing by and doing nothing as they pick off all what they think are the weak members of the herd. And that's all this is.
Exactly.
They're just clipping out the outside members of the herd while they surround it and get ready to eat us all.
Facebook gets content moderation wrong all the time. They take down speech that most reasonable people think shouldn't be taken down, and they leave up other speech that a lot of people think should be taken down.
The history of the left, the history of every form of the left, involves censorship. And in America, that means shutting down people so their voices can't be heard. And in the most extreme cases in history, it means kicking down your door in the middle of the night and hauling you off to a political prison so you can't speak anymore. They need us to not speak.
Labeling Diamond and Silk unsafe to the community.
They don't want us to be heard because basically an election is coming up. President Trump won this election by the people, we the people, through social media. And whenever they found out that's how he won it, that's why they're shutting down conservative voices, people that is pro-Trump. How is it that somebody can go on to Facebook, post derogatory pictures of our president with his head being cut off and so forth? They let that stay there. But then you got two black chicks who's down with politics standing there just talking up our president, the American people, being behind everything in his agenda, and they want to shut us down. Well, that's not going to work with Diamond and Silk.
So they're not platforms anymore. They're
exactly.
trying to remove voices and call everybody a Nazi. Well, that shouldn't be allowed, and somebody with some guts should step up.
There's also the risk, though, that the focus on these episodic, spectacular instances of censorship by Facebook distracts from what may be a more significant form of content moderation that Facebook engages in every day. And that is the decision they make every time you open your Facebook feed to show you some content and not other content.
The social media mega company sometimes ignores what is actually trending among its billion users if the story originated from a conservative news source. Let's talk to the guy who broke the story, Michael Nunez. He is the technology editor from Gizmodo who broke it. Michael, welcome. What did these former Facebook employees tell you?
So what they told me was that there was a system in place that allowed them to either blacklist or inject stories that weren't trending into the news feed. So in a sense, there were human curators that were actually affecting what was showing up on Facebook's trending news feed. For the last 2 years, Facebook has maintained that it's been an algorithm that's sorting these topics. So we obviously found these revelations to be pretty interesting, to say the least. We have found that actually a small group of 20 journalists that are recent graduates from East Coast private schools and often Ivy League schools are the ones that are actually activating a trend so that it can show up in your feed, or blacklisting it. So, it's not that Facebook has any bias here. It's that these young journalists are the ones that are choosing what trends and what doesn't. And the question then becomes whether you trust recent graduates to determine what the most important news of the day is.
And quickly, if you could, Michael, did you find any evidence of political bias being applied the other way on liberal sites like MSNBC.com or Daily Kos or Think Progress?
No, we didn't find any evidence of that. But, at least in one instance, we had a source that was maintaining a list for the course of a six month period in which he found items like Chris Kyle, Ted Cruz, Mitt Romney, and a variety of other conservative news topics that were blacklisted by Facebook's news curators. And in that case, they weren't allowed to trend on the news site.
There's a risk that Facebook embracing the power to decide who gets to speak and who doesn't get to speak in the largest online discourse ever constructed is a dangerous proposition. The idea that a single company will decide these questions will create a risk that others whose opinions we value more than, say, Alex Jones, will also get silenced.
What we're watching now in real time is this country become unfree. So the question is, who exactly is defending us in all of this? Us who might dissent from Mark Zuckerberg's view or think that NBC News maybe doesn't tell the whole truth all the time, or don't trust Mark Zuckerberg to control what we think. What about us?